Hey guys, welcome to the Anime Plus Podcast. My name is Jay Weston, and I'm with my co-host
Riper333. So many threes.
This is a special day, man. This is the first podcast episode.
First one.
Yeah, man.
Very, very excited.
Special day. Let's get into the topics. We're gonna go over.
Yeah. Let's go. Let's do this. So one of the first questions that we're gonna be asking is gonna be how we actually got started into anime.
And I'll go first.
All right.
So I got introduced with anime with Ghost in the Shell.
Ooh. Oh,
yeah, man. 6 years old, man. Ghost six? Yeah, man. You know that scene to where like she's like half, it's like a half a robot body, and it's like
you probably had a funny feeling in your
pulling off extremities. I know, right? Her titties out, fucking pulling out. She's like pulling out of this like wire that's hanging onto the ceiling.
Oh, Jesus.
I was just like, is this anime? What is this Japanese cartoon?
Is this considered porn?
And after that, like my older cousin was watching it, and you know, I didn't understand what was going on. And then I was trying to find out, like, okay, what other shows is going on? I'm like 6 or 7.
Yeah, you're like.
And then I found this? Pokemon, and I was like, okay, Pokemon.
There you go.
That's the best one. So Pokemon was my first real anime. Ghost in the Shell was like a shock. So I count it, but I don't count it. You know?
Okay.
What about you?
I'm also somewhat in the same way. My first anime, and I didn't see the whole thing. It was Akira.
That was how old were you?
Man, I was
Those say five.
Maybe five.
What?
Yeah.
Akira? Five. Akira's one of the best animes ever created, masterpiece.
But here's the thing. I saw it on TV, right? It was just it's Chance Encounter.
Yeah.
Now that I'm actually thinking about it, it was probably like 6 or 7 actually. It was a Chance Encounter. I was just flipping through
around
the channels.
Around the same age.
You know, flipping through the channels, and then it was almost at the end of it where spoiler warnings if you haven't seen Akira. All right, by the way, I'm probably butchering it, which
Akira,
is fine.
Akira.
Well, in Spanish, I would just say Akira.
Akira. I don't know, man.
Yeah, maybe.
There you go. Anyways,
but yeah, it was basically almost at the end when, again, spoiler warnings if you haven't seen it. When he becomes a blob at the end, almost at the end of the movie, he starts to become a blob, starts raising up and up and up and up and up. And the moment that really caught me was when he was trying to like get the female away, which I don't remember her name right now. The female away, and then she got enveloped. Enveloped in that blob, and then it was too much pressure, and she just exploded. Like if you exploded like those air bubbles for the packages.
Yeah.
And I was like, what? Am I supposed to be watching this? Am I allowed?
Yeah.
And then, I don't know, after that.
It's crazy.
It became Dirty Pair. After that.
Yeah. It's crazy, man. It's, yeah, that those are extreme animes. Like Ghost in the Shell and
Akira
for sure. Are like, they're like mature level.
For sure.
Much.
Oh yeah.
It's always you go to the mature level, you like get a glimpse of that matureness.
Yep.
And then you know tone it down, and then
I'm pretty sure
the next one was like Dragon Ball or like
the next one was
Yu-Gi-Oh or something.
Somewhat like of a Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Z, maybe Dirty Pair. One of those two.
Dirty Pair. What's that?
Yeah. Dirty Pair is somewhat of an older anime.
The
it's 80s? About two
80s anime?
I think so.
Yeah.
It's about two girls that are
Dirty Pair.
Yeah, I mean, they don't have dirty pairs on them, but it's about two girls who are cops, basically. Yeah. I've only watched like one or two episodes, and then it was all Dragon Ball Z.
And Dragon Ball, let's say Dragon Ball, okay? Dragon Ball sounds...
But here's the thing.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I didn't know that there was a Dragon Ball.
Yeah.
And then Dragon Ball Z.
Well, when I talk about Dragon Ball Z... In Dragon Ball GT, Dragon Ball Super, I just say Dragon Ball because that's the series. If you look at the manga and the anime, it's all derived from Dragon Ball, and then the manga is like Dragon Ball. Even when it goes to Z, it'll say Dragon Ball Z, but you know, Dragon Ball is kind of like the series name,
and very
Z
true,
is kind
very
of like
true.
The iterations of it. Z, Super, GT,
yeah. So. No. You're.
So I'll just say Dragon Ball for all of it before, you know, so it's not, so I'm not confused.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, no. But I started with Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah.
Which was where the power levels came in and the Super Saiyan, obviously, right? The Super Saiyan transformation. Super Saiyan. One about probably one of the biggest cutting the corners that was basically perfect. Because yeah. I know Akira Toriyama was like, I don't want to keep putting all the black in the hairs.
The ink.
Right? So, to save time and money, right? Yeah. We're going to go ahead and, hey, Super Saiyan!
Yeah, which is cool because it's like, okay, introducing a transformation. It was like an accidental, like, phenomenon, you know?
Strike
like,
gold. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Probably the best
thing. It was originally white, too. It wasn't supposed to be, like, yellow. They did that for the anime.
They did that for the anime.
You know, I found that out, I was just like, you know what? He probably didn't even think of the color for a lot of this stuff. No. You know? He's the most laziest creator ever.
But it worked.
Yeah.
I mean, you can say that, but at the end of the day, it worked.
How we watch anime now versus how we used to watch anime.
Yeah.
Because
we all had this
phase of watching anime from random anime sites.
Oh god, yeah.
Yeah.
So many viruses.
Yeah, yeah. I don't even want to talk about it because
it's almost like watching porn.
Yeah, man. You're definitely.
Like, oh, where is it from?
Free
oh,
anime site. Yeah, now, you know, I buy it. You know, I pay for subscriptions on Funimation.
Oh, for sure.
Crunchyroll, Funimation.
Crunchyroll now.
Yeah, just Crunchyroll now. Yeah, Funimation is kind of nixed. And I didn't even like the Funimation platform really because their videos were kind of wonky.
Okay.
You know, at least when I watched it on my PS4, you know, it's not really optimized for like game consoles. It's more
Oh god, it's so bad.
It's more like for computers.
Have you done it with the PlayStation 3?
PlayStation 3? What is a PlayStation 3?
Yeah, PlayStation 3.
That was a
Funimation.
Oh god. Okay. Yeah.
With Funimation.
Yeah.
Oh, it was so bad.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah.
I would put different types of anime as favorite and never came up. Always had to research it. You almost had to put like the anime's name like almost perfectly. I'm like, no.
Also, like it won't like guess for you.
Oh god, no.
It'd be like, oh, we don't know
what is happening.
We don't have Dragon Ball. We only have Dragon Ball.
Yeah. Exactly it.
Yeah.
Then we went to PlayStation 4. Yeah, PlayStation 4. I did it PlayStation 4, then I did it computer, obviously, right?
Yeah, yeah. Computers are always the better for those sites.
Oh god, yeah.
Because it's optimized for it. These apps, you know, they. I don't think a lot of developers put streaming. They don't optimize those apps for like the consoles. You know, it's always for like the computer or like your phone. Even for your phone, like Funimation on my phone worked perfectly fine.
Yeah, yeah.
But then Funimation on PS4 is just like. It's like, oh, we can't find this anime. And I'm like, no, it's right here. Oh, my phone.
I can see it.
Yeah. What?
God.
You can't find Dragon Ball? There's no Dragon Ball. There's no Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball is the most popular anime.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. Like, well, it's here. Well,
not the.
The, but it's the most recognizable.
It has to be. Yeah. It has to be. I think it's been, what? I think the anime started at 1997? Or ended at 1997.
No, man. 80s. Dragon Ball.
Yeah.
Still stuck on Z.
Yeah, I mean, that was the first one, so yeah, I'm definitely stuck on Z.
And even Toriyama had a show before that called Dr. Slug? Dr. something.
I think I know what you're talking
about. You know what I mean? Because on the manga, it has like his little Toriyama. Like a miniature chibi.
Miniature,
guy.
Yeah. I think it has a gas mask.
Yeah,
or
gas
something.
Mask. Yeah. It was Doctor whatever, and that had Aroli.
Yeah, the gag character.
Yeah, the gag character
that came up in Dragon Ball Super. Dragon Ball Super.
Yeah,
as the most powerful being.
Yeah, it was weird. I was like,
what?
There's only one guy before Monaka. Monaka with the nipples, dude.
Oh god,
man. Yeah, that was so weird, man. Toriyama's a weird guy, man. He's a character.
But hey, man, I think.
What other sites did you used to go to?
I don't know if anybody remembered LimeWire.
What? LimeWire?
LimeWire.
Of course
Wire.
I remember LimeWire.
Okay, all right.
That's all where right. you get all your viruses from.
My point with viruses.
Yes. So you, many viruses. Yes. I had a Windows, dude. I had a Windows Acer computer. My dad okay. used it for gaming back in the day. He did like World of Warcraft, right?
Okay.
And he played that a lot. And then when he stopped playing World of Warcraft, he gave me the computer. And I was like, oh, yeah, I'm going to watch porn.
God, I got a computer.
I'm going to watch porn. But
first thing a teenage boy would do it.
And now I can watch my porn. No, but yeah. So, you know, I got it and I started watching, downloaded LimeWire, and I fucking, yeah, downloaded everything, and my computer crashed. I was like,
exactly. There was one time, I had the same experience. It was one time my computer crashed. It went in and started going with this weird display of like, I don't even remember what it said. I remember calling my sister because she was pretty good with computers.
So. Yeah.
Oh my God, the computer, something happened. And then she goes, this is like, what do you do?
Oh, you said the timer. Okay.
And I was like, oh, I was downloading a game.
Game?
I was not. I was downloading porn. Anime porn. Anime porn. Yeah.
Hentai.
Oh,
man.
Not hentite. Hentai. Yeah, dude. And completely crashed the computer. Like, we're talking like the computer was...
Were you downloading whole videos or clips?
I think it was a video. You can always preview the video too. Until you could always preview the video until where it was downloaded.
Oh, okay.
Or the pictures. If it was 60%, then you could see half of it.
Yeah.
Oh, the good part. Day.
Yeah, you guys don't understand how it was for us back before it was a high speed Wi-Fi.
Yeah. Know. What is Wi-Fi? Yeah. What is Wi-Fi?
We had dial-up.
Oh, God.
Dial-up with the cord. Oh,
jeez,
man.
Beanie.
Oh, yeah. AOL. You had to like download your porn and like the picture, and it would like you could see like the model, see her face. And then you can see her chest, and then you're trying to wait until you see her,
oh
like,
God,
her nipple.
Oh, God.
Something.
I could see it.
You can see the nipple. See the nipple. And then it crashes.
And then
it's a virus, really. Ah, gotcha. It's a virus.
That's
or
probably
like,
how it was.
It's like Jesus. There.
But I will admit.
It's like Jesus with the, you know, that meme where it's like, you know how like you like click on a picture and it's like, it looks like a.
Oh, yeah. Like and then suddenly it turns into a Jesus.
It's like Jesus,
meme.
Like. You better stop. I see you. Jesus there. Yeah. Okay, go ahead. Sorry.
What are you watching? That's where actually I got some of my Dragon Ball Z movies, like Broly. Dragon Ball Z Broly,
oh,
the movies and
the
stuff like that.
Original Broly?
Yeah, the original Broly.
Yeah. Kakarot!
That's all he said the whole
Jesus
time.
Yeah,
Kakarot! Because his father always spoke for him. Not to mention there was two more of those movies, although Bio Broly wasn't as good.
It was Second Coming.
Yeah, Broly Second Coming. Then
Bio,
it was
Bio Broly.
Yeah, like, yeah, I don't think anybody did really.
I think the best part of that movie was the Family Kamehameha, though.
Of course. Yeah, oh yeah, for sure. One. For sure.
So many.
It had to be. Yeah. So when we're talking about optimization, is that how you say it?
Yeah, right? Optimization.
On the PS4. So, on the PS5, it's actually very well.
Is it?
It's pretty amazing.
Ah, man. See, I'm not on the PS5 wave, man. You know me, I barely play video. I need to get into video games because...
Well, to be honest, like, with a kid...
It's hard, man.
It's hard.
So hard, yeah.
So hard.
I have a 4-year-old and still hard. So, imagine having a baby. Still have a baby.
He's almost about to be 2 now.
Yeah. I think when he turns about 2.5 or on the way to 3, he's going to start being independent a little bit. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Unless you're...
Oh, God, thank you.
Unless your wife, like, babies him, then he's going to be a mama's boy like my son. My son is such a mama's boy. He loves his mother so much, which is good. But if we had a girl, she'd be a daddy.
She'd be a daddy girl. Yeah,
you know.
I have 2 boys. Like,
You got two boys.
There's no chance for me.
Yeah, no chance. Maybe this one will love you more.
Fighting for their affection.
Their affection. I only like my mom. It's like two guys there. You're just like, what about me? And she's just like, nah.
I'm good. But yeah, I don't know anything about the Xbox side though.
Xbox is good. It's good.
I think so too.
Experiences with Xbox and the optimization of the apps there.
Okay.
I think PS4 doesn't really care too much about their apps. You know? I don't think so. PS4 anymore.
PS5 does.
PS5, I'll say that. I'm sure for PS5 they did, and they redid it.
PS5 is pretty good. Like I said, I just don't know about the Xbox ones. All right, the next question is your favorite anime moments. Now, with that, right? We're not going to be doing a tier list or anything like that.
Nope.
That might be maybe a future video or something like that.
Yeah, like a ranking. We're not doing ranking top anime moments of all
time. Yeah. No, we're not doing it. It's all about our opinion, right?
Opinion, yeah. And we'll go about like when you're a kid versus like now. Like, oh, you know what? I appreciate this one more. But when I was a kid, it was this one. But now it's like, okay, it's that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay, so you want to start it off?
Yeah. Okay.
All right, go ahead.
So when I was a kid, obviously, Super Saiyan, man. Of course. Like, Goku turns Super Saiyan when he turns Super Saiyan 1.
Okay. You know,
that's amazing. Everybody wants to go Super Saiyan, man.
Oh, God, yeah.
Everybody. Like, everybody tried.
That buildup of rage.
Everyone
tried. Not to mention Frieza was very much playing that character very well.
Yeah,
I'm saying playing character like he was an actor.
Yeah. Everybody hated Frieza, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
So, you know, as a kid, Super Saiyan. But as an adult,
okay.
I think it was more... Because now I think about the story and the plot more.
Okay.
You know? So I think when Naruto turned Sage Mode for the first time.
Whoa.
Yeah, man. It's because Jiraiya died, man.
That's true. Very character.
Hinata. You know what I mean? All those emotions.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, that impacted me more.
Okay. All right.
As a person.
Okay.
You know, Dragon Ball's Dragon Ball. You know, fighting for the sake of fighting.
It's like if
Dragon Ball was like purely just fighting, it'd be God of High School.
Oh, that's true.
God of High School. You're mine. But yeah, no, so. Yeah, I would say that. What about you?
Funny enough, we have somewhat of a similar type.
Yeah.
It was Goku moment of him turning into Super Saiyan was cool. But I believe mine was Teen Gohan going to Super Saiyan 2.
Oh yeah. That one was nice too. Okay.
Yeah. That was good too. I think the biggest reason
I love Gohan.
Right? It's because I love Gohan.
Yeah.
I love Gohan so much, which is why I'm very excited to see that Dragon Ball Super superhero movie.
Yeah.
August 19. Yeah. And I think this is going to be in Crunchyroll. I'm not sure. But, I know that the movie's already out in Japanese. But, all right. How Japanese voice actors do their thing, right?
The screaming?
Yeah. The screaming, it's their way. And I'm not knocking it. But I grew up watching it in English. Again, very loved by their fans, for sure.
The English dub is like...
But Sean Schimmel, my friend. Sean Schimmel,
yeah.
Those screams and those octaves
lose your voice scream.
Wow. Oh, yeah. I bet after a pretty good screaming session, it's like... You know what I think what they do? Sometimes, maybe.
What?
They probably just pre-record screaming.
Yeah.
And they just
sounds right, because we have the technology.
We can build it better.
We can build it better and stronger, faster, longer.
So, but yeah, Teen Gohan. Just because Gohan was always not a punching bag, but we always knew that he had the potential, right?
Yeah.
And at the time that I was watching, I was probably about... I don't know, maybe 13, 14-ish. Maybe when I watched it in Toonami.
Yeah. I mean, everybody was that age.
Oh, man.
Teen Gohan go crazy. Yeah.
I always had to watch Sailor Moon because my sister liked Sailor Moon so much. I was like, oh, my God. I don't want to watch Sailor Moon.
You know what's funny?
We're
going off topic just for a minute. And my wife loves Sailor Moon.
She does?
Yeah,
all right.
She loves Sailor Moon. She has a bunch of, like, pop, what was it?
Funkos?
Funko Pops, yeah. A bunch of Funko Pops with Sailor Moon, you know. She bought like 3 or 4, you know. Jeez. So, and we watched the new ones. The new Sailor Moon sucks.
Oh, Crystal, right?
Yeah, well, it doesn't suck. It's just that's not me. That's not my guy. That's not my thing.
Okay.
She likes Sailor Moon. She doesn't like the new one. She likes the old one.
Yeah. The old one probably holds so part of her in there.
Yeah, but man, if
nostalgia.
If you watch the old one, you know how whiny she is.
Oh.
The girl who plays Sailor Moon.
Oh god, yeah.
Usagi or
she's yeah, Usagi, yeah.
Yeah, she's so whiny, man.
Oh god, yeah.
She whines about everything, and my wife is like, oh, she's an Aquarius. I mean, no, she's a Pisces. So yeah, I'm like, I don't know what that means.
Me neither.
What is it? That's what Pisces whine? Oh, hey, well, Pisces whine.
So, are you a Pisces?
Pisces. I don't whine. I don't whine. I'm a brick house. I'm a stone wall. My heart is made of.
I'm a rock, and rock don't move.
Yeah, rock don't move. Yeah, man.
If you guys don't know, that's from Matt TV.
Yeah, yeah. Back in the day.
Oh,
you're showing your age right now. I know.
Oh, God. So old.
Matt TV was like, what, early 2000s?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, like early, not 2006, like 2002.
Yeah. Early.
Yeah.
Man, Matt TV, I feel like Matt TV was a gem for a while.
Yeah.
Cast members and stuff like that started changing, and then it kind of started changing. And
yeah.
It wasn't as good, but also that goes with time, because we can say this about any television news network now, with how the genre, more like the atmosphere.
Yeah,
you can't say some things, you know. You can't joke.
Sensitive.
Yeah.
Even with this podcast, man, we're just worried about, you know, including everybody.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, you gotta be inclusive.
If you don't know, I'm African American. I'm black, and my guy. Here, Puerto Rican. So it's like we're technically minorities, but we're not trying to have an agenda. You know, we're
exactly.
Just talk about anime because we love anime.
Yeah, we should just love anime.
Manga, weebiness stuff,
and you know,
otaku stuff. Yeah,
and you know what's the funny thing about this is, I do have
what's funny
Puerto Rican flag everywhere I go. Gotta represent.
Oh, really? I didn't know that. Wow. Yeah, I didn't know you had a Puerto Rican flag in your car or on your desk at work.
Or my desk at work.
Yeah, you probably have one in your pocket just in case. What am I? I'm a Puerto Rican. Here you go. Look, here you go.
Here it is.
Here it is. The proof. I'm Puerto Rican.
The proof.
Yeah. And apparently all black people like with Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper. Yeah.
I love Dr. Pepper. I love it. I love watermelon.
Here it comes out.
The stereotypes, man. I love it. I mean, some stereotypes are good. You know?
I do like rice.
Rice and beans. Rice and beans. But who doesn't like that?
I know. It's very hard.
Like, unless you're a child and you're like, I don't like vegetables. Oh. I don't like vegetables.
Oh, my.
I don't like beans.
Oh, then. Like... Okay, then my kid is very Puerto Rican because he's all about it.
Yeah. My son's Puerto Rican, too.
Very true.
Puerto Rican too. That's my wife's true. Puerto Rican. So yeah. My son's Puerto Rican. He's not even black.
Yeah.
He's just Puerto
the
Rican.
The next Miles Morales out there.
Oh yeah. You know what? Hey.
Why not, right?
You know, by the time they make that movie, he might be of age.
Yeah, he probably would be. But yeah, So going back into those favorite anime moments, but yeah, Teen Gohan, you know, he was always a protector.
Oh yeah, that was the subject.
That was the subject. Not the protector, but we always knew there was a hidden potential that he had.
Hinted the whole series.
Whole time during Dragon Ball Z. I feel like it resonated with me at that time. I was doing karate as well. I was going up in those belts and stuff like that. And then because of Dragon Ball Z, actually, I'm like, oh, I want to fight and stuff like that. I mean, I knew that I couldn't fly or do Kamehameha.
Yeah.
That did not stop me from just saying Kamehameha.
I mean, everybody says that, dude. I used to say that. I used to try to go Super Saiyan, right?
And I just get super angry.
Yeah. My brother, right? My little brother. I'll go Super Saiyan, right? And my brother would watch it just because I'm watching it, right? But he would really try. Like, I'm doing it, but I'm pretending.
Yeah. You know for a fact you're pretending.
My brother's like 4. he's like about to implode. You see his face?
Oh God.
Jesus, his face is like the reddest thing ever. And he's and he's black. So like it's hard.
Oh God.
It's hard for a black person to turn red. They normally turn purple.
It's not impossible.
Yeah, you know, well, we're not that dark, but it's like, you know, you see him turning red. I'm just like, dude, my God. Breathe. Breathe.
God, oh God! Oh God! Breathe. Stop it!
The mom, mom! He's not breathing.
Yeah, but, he's not breathing.
Yeah. So.
So yeah. So that resonated when I was a kid, right? And now I think, off the top of my head, without going so insightful, I think one of the top moments is in My Hero Academia.
Like now?
Yeah. Now, like okay. Me being an adult with a kid and stuff like that. When All Might battles All For One.
Ooh, the last time?
The last time. Ooh. Where it has those embers and then it's and then it does the
yeah, I get nothing in tingles right now.
Oh, I am too. I am right now. And then he goes in and after he gets he defeats All For One and stuff like that. Has that burst of the flame and then goes to the crew, like to the camera crew, and then just points. Yeah. Oh my goodness.
That's why I'm like getting tingles, because I can visualize this scene yeah. so perfectly right now.
I mean, at the time, I was
if you don't know, we like kid. My Hero Academia.
Oh yeah. God, yeah.
Anime plus Ultra.
Oh. no, we're not. We're not doing that one.
Anime plus. Anime, just plus. Anime plus. Logo. Ooh, the logo looks nice.
The logo does look nice.
Well, you'll see.
We'll push it out later, but it's really good. And that resonated a lot with me because I have at the time I was in my way to having that first kid, and he's my, you know, I feel like once you see a kid, especially your own child, all you see is potential. Yeah. Right? All you see is like, man, it could be great. It could be great. And that's like passing that torch. Or something like that. So it's just me visualizing that moment of like my son rising up to the occasion and passing and being me being able to pass the torch. What torch? I have no idea.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, your lineage, you know?
Exactly. Maybe that's what it is. Like, be out in the world and know he can make it. And know that he'll be a good member of society.
Yeah.
So
obviously, that's what we all want as parents.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And yeah,
two kids, man. How's it feel having two kids?
Oh man, I don't know.
I still feel like a kid.
Oh, for sure,
right? Don't you feel like a kid sometimes, and then like you have bills.
Oh God, I know. My wife says that all the time. Like, who's the kid? Especially when we go to the pool.
Yeah. Are you the kid? I don't know. Maybe.
Oh yeah. Oh God. When I'm in the pool, I'm like.
With that face.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
And I'm very much a kid in the pool.
Yeah, everybody's a kid in the pool.
But my kid, my actual kid, just somewhat cries. I guess I bully him too much on the crew.
He doesn't like the pool?
He likes the pool. He just doesn't like what I do to him on it. Yeah, I always like pouring water over him. He's like, oh, stop, papa, no.
You're a bully.
To my kid, yes.
If I don't do it, someone else is gonna do it.
Exactly, yeah. And trying to get him hard, strong. All right.
Yeah, man. Trying to
for the world.
Make him hard. Make him hard. My son is so soft, dude.
Oh, come on.
He's so soft, man. He's a sensitive guy. He's not. He's very outgoing though.
But he's a kid. You know, all kids are sensitive.
I'm gonna tell you the story, right?
God.
He's at the park, right?
Okay.
And for some reason, he likes to like. Play with nothing but like the older girls, so he has like an older girl
and that's something,
right? Yeah,
I feel like that's big brain right there.
Yeah, big brain yeah, thinking ahead.
Yeah.
But he's like, so he's four and he's like hanging out with these like 8-year olds, right? He's just like,
ooh.
Hey, play with me, watch me go down the slide, blah, 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 blah. And then like they don't like it's
don't
funny because like they'll play with him for like a cool hour, right?
Oh wow.
Hour at the park. So
you should be so grateful to those girls.
Yeah,
like, oh, thank you.
But he's so cute to where like they can't say no. So he's like, play with me, please.
Oh,
and she's just
man.
Like, oh, okay, I'll play with you. He's so cute. And then they're playing, and then you know he stops playing, and they're just like, I don't want to play anymore. He's like, okay. He goes to another girl. He's like, can you watch me play? And then they're like,
whoa.
He so goes he just to jumps another from girl to girl, and I'm just like, if they don't want to play with you, go play with someone else.
Yeah.
But he takes that. And instead of playing with someone his age, he's playing with like an older girl. I'm just like, dude, go play with like one of those dudes. And when he plays with the other kids his age, he's always a leader, you know?
Okay.
He's like a leader.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, he really is. But he's like,
I feel like my kid is just gonna get pushed around.
He's peer pressure.
Oh.
He's like, go down the slide. Go down and go. If you don't go, I'm gonna go.
Do it.
And then after I go, I'm gonna push you. I'm gonna push you if you go. Do it. Do it. Do it. Now. I'm like, literally. And he's like down there pushing kids down slides.
Great coach. Yeah. Great coach.
And I'm just like, you don't have to force me.
Make display.
I want to do it. I'm like, yeah, you want to do it, but maybe they don't want to do it. But these kids just like have no backbone. They just let him. He's not a bully.
And he's four.
He's
huh?
not a bully because he's like, you know, he has manners and he's, you know, he's
okay.
But he's so pushy. He's so pushy.
My kid has no manners at all. He's like, if you don't give me what I want, I am gonna cry.
I'm gonna cry. It's like
I mean, we let him cry. I'm like, all right, hey, okay, go ahead, cry. You are fed. You don't have a dirty diaper. You know, there's no sun in your face, or you're not really hot. You're not really cold.
Yeah.
You just crying to cry now. I'm just gonna let you cry now.
Yeah. All right, guys, thank you for tuning in to the Anime Plus podcast. This is our first episode. I hope you guys have a nice day and tune in for the next one. See you guys later.